So we'll get inside the data guard troubleshooting steps and see how can we troubleshoot a data guard. So let us revisit the data guard components. We know that there is a production server, we know that there is a standby server, and we also know that there is something called as log shipping service, which works over the network. And if there is issue with the network, definitely your log shipping service won't work. And there will be one log apply service, and log apply service, the job is to apply all the received archive logs from production to the standby server. So how do we troubleshoot the data guard? First of all, we have to check the status of production database. Now, when we talk about the production status, nothing but check whether your production is up and running or not. Because sometimes if somebody stops the production server, then definitely it won't be able to send the archives from production to the DR. So if your production is stopped, then definitely your DR MRP won't start, because nothing is coming from production, then what it will apply. First thing you must always check is to check the production server status. Next is you need to check your archive destination to state. It must be enabled. Now this check you need to perform on the production, because we have configured the archive destination to send archives from production to the DR server. Now if this archive dest to state is disabled or it is set to differ, then definitely it won't be able to send the archives from production to the DR. Next is we need to check the network between the production and the DR. So how do we check? We need to perform a TNS ping. And next we need to check the log sequence on the production. And we check the log sequence because we have to match this log sequence with the DR server. Next, we need to connect to the DR server and check the standby status. Now, why are we checking the standby status? Because you can start the MRP process only when your standby server is minimum in mount state. So if your standby server is in no mount state or your standby is not up and running, then definitely there is an issue. So we need to check the status of the standby server. Next, we need to check MRP process status. Also check the MRP log sequence number. It should be exactly equal to the production log sequence. So whatever the archive log sequence running on your production server, your MRP log sequence should be same. Now when you see both these are equal, it means that your data guard configuration is in sync. If you still have issues, then what you can do is you can dig more into the alert log of your production server and also alert log of your DR server.